A lot of developed and developing nations are making promises to achieve net zero emission targets. Some have set their targets to 2030, while many others have pushed their targets to 2050 or 2070. Now, how is that really going to help fight climate change? Luckily, we have the answers for you right here. We see various world leaders pledging to achieve net zero emissions at COP26. The world really holds responsibility to ensure man-made gases are reduced and removed. Only when there is balance created between green greenhouse emissions and the atmosphere can the Earth's climate balance come to zero. So how can we reduce or remove negative emissions? Carbon dioxide is the only greenhouse gas that can be absorbed by the atmosphere. There are two ways of doing it. One, by ensuring that we enable and stimulate nature to absorb more, or secondly, by having technology that can do the job for you. Now, to limit global warming to 1.5 degrees Celsius, it is necessary and important to either remove or store carbon dioxide, which means carbon dioxide removal, or also called CDR. Now, how is CDR linked to net zero emissions? Well, CDR is indeed linked to net zero, which means the earlier we achieve net zero, the less CDR would be required. Now, CDR can be divided into three different processes: biological, technological, and geochemical. Firstly, biological. As we've learned through our childhood science lessons, plants absorb carbon dioxide naturally through the atmosphere. So there are two ways of doing it: through afforestation or reforestation, which means carbon dioxide will be absorbed by the plants and trees in the atmosphere and through that reduce carbon emissions. Secondly, technological. There are ways to ensure that carbon dioxide that is emitted through industrial plants are trapped from the exhaust gas pipes and stored either underground or someplace else. And finally, geochemical. It can be done through ocean productivity, which means phytoplanktons are plants that are suspended or are in the water. They produce large amounts of organic matter. To make sure that countries make efforts to meet these criteria, the concept of global net zero was developed. It is different from net zero, which are country pledges and countries would have to come to net zero. Global net zero is a more wider term wherein developed countries will have to take the onus to reduce emissions more to enable and help developing countries to grow and develop better. If you look at global emissions, China is the highest polluter, followed by United States of America and India. But this data does not really provide historical data of emissions by various developed nations. In order to know which country emitted how much and what the responsibility stands, the idea and concept of global net zero was developed. Recently at COP26, India pledged to achieve net zero by 2070. This came as a surprise to many, but it also showed commitment that developing countries can also achieve net zero emission targets while developing. Prime Minister Narendra Modi, during his speech, spoke of India's track record to fight climate change in the recent few years. He also made five promises at COP26 and ensured that the world got the message of how important and urgent it is to fight climate change. Prime Minister Modi said that it is not just India pledging to the world in this fight against climate change, but it is 125 crore Indians promising themselves to achieve the target.